Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Excuse me, I was doing my eyebrows, I laminate my eyebrows, so it's like perming them so they sit straighter. I was just on YouTube watching my usual like true crime countdowns and then Shay Mitchell's 58 step beauty guide from a face mask to false eyelashes video popped up. And I remember a few people tagged me in this and I don't do reaction videos because who am I to judge anyone's skincare routine, but I love Shay Mitchell, first of all because Pretty Little Liars is one of my guilty pleasures, but also that, was it like the cleansing wipe advert she did where she pretended to remove her mascara? It was the best thing I've ever seen. It was so bad, but I thought it was so funny. Illegal, but funny. So I thought while I'm laminating my eyebrows, I'll actually kind of do some work, I guess, and record a reaction to this video. As I mentioned, I've got no license. I got no education in skincare. These are just for fun and seeing how we react to her routine. My alarm will go off for me to do something to my eyebrows and I'll be back. But let's start. What I'm going to say about this, first of all, usually when Vogue like to do this thing where it's like 58 steps, but they'll include a step like lemon water is one of the steps, or putting a towel around your hair, step two. You know, they do all things. It's not necessarily going to be 58 steps of, you know, like 25 steps of skincare, etc. Or is it? I don't know. Let's have a look. Why am I laughing? I don't even know what's happening yet. Okay, cool.
Hi guys, Shay Mitchell here. I'm going to take you through my skincare routine and my everyday makeup look. There are quite a few steps, so stick with me.
We will. Stunning. There's no filter being used from what I can see on my iPad, which I think, in my opinion, Harper's use sometimes. But yeah, beautiful.
Every single morning when I wake up, I may or may not check my phone. So when I come in the bathroom, the first thing I have to do is wash my hands. So my next step is my cleanser. This cleanser is super gentle. It's like the perfect sort of balance for my skin. I found this at a drugstore in Canada, and then I add about that much.
No idea what that cleanser is, never heard of it before. Should we have a look? Am I gonna do this? Are we actually gonna look for everything? All right, the link is to Sephora, which we don't have in the UK, so unfortunately I can't see that product. Yeah, we don't get on the Sephora website here, unfortunately. But I do like those manual scrubby things. I love my Foreo. For me, I don't know if there's any science behind it, I don't know what it is. You do not need to use a brush to have a good cleanser. Your fingertips are fine, but I do find with continuous use, the pores, especially on my nose, tend to look good. They look really good. My lips are so dry. Okay, let's carry on.
And I feel like this also helps just like exfoliate a little bit as well.
Yeah, it will do very gently, you know, not a huge thing, but yeah, gentle.
So I keep a little fridge in my bathroom, and this guy is one of the things that I keep in there. It's a little ice roller. Oh, it just feels so nice.
I have nothing against mini fridges, unless you think that keeping a product cold is going to make it better in any way. But mini fridges are great if you just want to keep your stuff feeling nice and cold. Things like eye patches, face masks, rollers, stuff like that feel great when it's cold. This is a great de-puffing step to do in the morning. I personally like my ice globes. You can get just like a cold spoon. It will do the job.
One thing I love to do is do under eye masks. It just allows your makeup to set on really nice without being super greasy underneath.
This is a step people often get wrong, and I'll be interested to see what she uses after, because essentially eye patches are just serums with that kind of like layer on top to help everything penetrate the skin better, and makeup will sit nicer on it because a lot of serums contain nice hydrating plumping ingredients that allows the makeup to sit nicely over the top. If she uses like a toner or washes this away after, it's a bit of a waste of time. Like usually people team these up with a clay mask or wash off mask, and you're just washing off all that serum you've just put on your face. So but yeah, I'm a fan of eye patches too.
Now, you're gonna see quite a few masks. And the reason why I like them is just because I feel like they're very hydrating. I put them on, I don't have to think about it. I love the drama of it. I think they look funny. I like to scare people when I'm traveling, especially, or when I'm just at home.
See, that's what I love. Like when I wasn't angry at 58 step, because whether it's 58 skincare steps, which you do not need and can actually cause some irritation for most normal skin types, her skin clearly loves it by the look of her skin. But also, I can take my time. I can take like an hour to 2 hours if I had the time doing my skincare routine because I love it. Like she says, the drama of it, the spectacle of it, the showmanship of it. Do you know what I mean? Like even if it's just you in a room, it feels nice to do.
So this is Lash Patch and it's hydrating lip gels. If I have time, I really go full out with my skincare because it's like, why not? It feels good. I'm going to also do this forehead mask. As you can see, I make a lot of expressions in my face. This is by Skin Iceland. Everything feels so cool. I'm like a skin mask superhero right now.
You know when someone's so pretty, it's annoying. Like she's beautiful, she's beautiful. And I've heard through friends of friends that she's a genuinely really nice person as well to work with. One thing I will say, I think she's putting that forehead mask on in a kind of attempt to reduce wrinkles, fine lines, all that kind of stuff. A lot of these masks, as I said, just have a serum in that are usually like hyaluronic acid based. You'll find that they have like a few different molecular weights of hyaluronic acid, which can cause some nice temporary plumping for the day. So knock yourself out of them, expect temporary results, but nothing crazy. They're the kind of results that only you would see. Don't mean looking in the mirror and you're like, oh wow, that's made a difference. Nothing permanent, very temporary, very nice, not harmful, so knock yourself out.
But this next mask that I'm gonna put on is by 111 or 111 Skin, I don't know. Okay, so now we're fully covered. I never like to waste the juice of the mask, so I pour it into my hands and I rub it on my neck.
There's nothing wrong with multi-masking like she's doing it. It's actually better that she's using all kind of like sheet masks or point masks, you know, focusing on different areas of the face rather than using like old clay wash-off masks, like I said, because it's just a waste. And yeah, save that juice, put it on your neck. Again, it's just a serum. You may as well make the most of it.
I have this really cool item that I actually found when I was in Japan because I obviously scoured their whole skin section there. Perfect lifting premium V mask. It looks like this. So you just put it under like this and then you wrap it around your ears like so. I mean, it feels like it's doing something and I kind of figure out like those bands you use when you're working out.
So I have a lot of those as well and they do work. They work very temporary. I don't know if there's a science behind it, if it is like, you know, like waist trainers. I don't really know. Let me know if you know, but I would use them before like I film a video just to give me a more chiseled look. I've not today, obviously, but there's only so much they can do. But yeah, I like those as well. Again, I don't know if there's any science behind these particular things though, but let me know if you know. I can see why the steps are racking up here.
I actually got this from Honest. Thank you, Jessica. So I want to keep all of this on for like a good 15 minutes. Then this is crucial to keeping everything intact.
I love this so far. I know it's ridiculous, but I actually really like this. This is what I do. I use a reusable mask from a brand called Experiments. And you don't have to use sheet masks. You can just use your favorite serum, put it in, rub it in a little bit, less than usual. Then I use the Do Skin reusable under eye patches, then the reusable mask to lock it all in. And it just gives this like extra dewy, hydrated look to your skin. These are things that have been around in Japan for ages. And they're usually just to keep your sheet mask on so you can walk around the house doing like chores and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, I like this. I haven't like nothing against this so far. I was expecting something really, really ridiculous. It might get like worse, but I have no issue with this so far. Oh, my eyebrows again, sorry. 15 minutes. Okay. Okay, let's carry on.
I have this wand. This is actually by Nurse Jamie.
She may as well have just used that ice roller that she used before. Essentially, it's the same thing, and that one's very expensive. I was gonna say overpriced, but you know, that's relative, but yeah, a bit of again an unnecessary step, not harmful. She loves it. It feels great for her.
24 karat breast masks. Your boobs need love too, you know, especially if you're going on an event and you have a low cut dress. So here they are. Okay, guys, so there you have.
I have a bit of an issue with these gold carrot masks, because you can get these on like AliExpress for 20 pence per mask, and they come in all different shapes, all different things. A lot of brands are taking them, white labeling, private labeling, putting their own brand, their own designs on and all that kind of stuff, their own logo. So it's hard to tell what's actually worth the money and what's, you know, of their own creation. And a lot of these sell for a lot, like crazy prices, like 90 quid for like a gold face mask, which when you look it up, it's on AliExpress for 20 to 50p. But yeah, always do your skincare neck down here. I always do up here as well. Again, it's just that hydration, it's moisturizing. It's make sure your actives get there as well. You don't have to have any special mask, anything like that. You just bring your skincare down.
Without being a little R-rated, trust that this is on correctly. It goes right around here and here. What I like to do for my chest area while all of this is sitting is use this La Mer Moisturizing Cool Gel Cream. I take a little bit of it out like that.
La Mer is pricey. It's very, very pricey, and often people say it's not worth it because it's pretty much Nivea in a pot. I used to agree, but I tend to be of the opinion now that it depends on the formulation. It's like giving the same ingredients to a professional chef or me. Do you know what I mean? Like, who's gonna make the better cake with the exact same ingredients, you know? It's very, very pricey. Let's see if I can see. Oh, hang on. Let's have a look at that boob thing. Boob. Oh, it's from Boohoo. $38. Not bad. Necessary? Not really. Fun? Yeah, why not? Why not care for those? La Mer Moisturizing Cool Gel Cream. If this is Sephora again, I'm so sorry. I'm gonna have to look at it somewhere else. La Mer's iconic Creme de La Mer is transformed into a refreshing gel, quenching the skin with hydration and nutrients. The Moisturizing Cool Gel Cream offers lightweight hydration, ideal for oily or combination skin types. That's very interesting. Let's see the actual ingredients. I mean, it doesn't look bad. It's got some really nice ingredients here that are gonna hydrate, but also help keep all that hydration in. Lots of nice oils as well. Niacinamide, glycerin, sodium hyaluronate, squalane. You got some nice seaweed extract, which is nice and moisturizing. I think that's La Mer's thing. I think, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think like that's their like thing. Fair bit of fragrance, so if that's not your thing, you're not gonna like it. But yeah, like put it everywhere, drench your skin, quench it, moisturize it. Why not? And a perfect step to do it as well, because once all that's off, you know, she'd already applied basically her serum and then moisturize, and then she can still bring all that down. It's just as, you know, an extra layer of moisture.
Ta-da! Okay, so now that I've taken everything off, this is the time when I like to go in and just massage my face. So if I feel like I need a little bit of extra serum before I go in and do my facial massage, I like to use this rose serum. This is by 123 Farm. And I just put a couple drops on my hand.
Let's take a look at that, because that looked a bit oily. Rose face serum with rosebud. Help moisturize and restore aging. Made quality oils that help your skin. Hoba argan. Here would be my personal issue with including this in this stage of the routine and this product for me personally. This for me isn't what I would class as a serum. It's an oil. It's a oil elixir, shall we say. So you have baobab oil, argan oil, jojoba seed oil, rosehip oil, pomegranate oil, rose oil, lavender oil, patchouli oil, and vitamin E. This isn't a serum. For me, a serum is something that isn't an oil. This is an oil. This is a facial oil. I personally wouldn't have it in this stage because I like to do this after moisturizing, depending on the types of oils, depending what's in my moisturizer. And I just don't like it when brands call their oils serums because it's too confusing. Like, serums for me are products that target a particular skincare concern, whether that's hydration, fine lines, wrinkles, brightening skin, evening skin tone, redness, all that kind of stuff, usually containing an active. They don't have to, but they usually do, and it's usually for me the stage that I would spend most money on. I personally wouldn't want to spend this much money on a mix of oils that, to be honest, for my skin personally wouldn't have many benefits for her. It's nice. I guess this is more of a sensorial experience, but let's see what she says about it. But yeah, I wouldn't call this a serum.
Rub it in. I do use my hands, and I'm always pretty gentle with the skin, and I would only do this if I had enough serum that was easy to glide over on my skin.
Okay, so she's using this particular serum, as she said, because she likes to do a facial massage. So doing a massage is a perfect time to use an oil, because obviously your hands, your tools, your whatever will glide across your face without causing any irritation. You may get a bit of redness and flushing, but perfect time to do it. I would usually do this pre or post moisturizer.
So this wash that I use is from Wilding. I come in here about 3 strokes. Always pretty gentle with this, just because you don't want to pull your skin, otherwise it will do the opposite. I like to give it a little zinger when I hit the end. And then I come in with this flatter side, pull that.
Makes sense why she's using that. I just wouldn't use it at this stage personally.
So I am quite a believer in anything you can do to depuff your skin. So if I'm getting ready for an event or, you know, any sort of photo shoot, then I like to make sure that a few days before I don't load up on sodium, because my skin does puff up quite easily. So I drink a lot of water before an event. I don't eat a lot of salt. And then I'm a big believer in lymphatic drainage, especially for my body, but also for my face. You really do notice just how much your skin has just released a lot of the fluid. And again, I sleep on my face. That's why sometimes when I wake up in the morning, I feel a little bit like a pufferfish.
I've had a busy social month, and I can see it on my face, I can see it my breakouts, I can feel it as well. I do get very puffy very quick. I get some comments in videos, which I don't mind, but I tend to not want them, where people are like, oh, you look like you lost weight in this one, and then, oh, have you put on weight in this one? It's because, like, I get so easily puffed up from, I wouldn't say lymphatic drainage, but like things like sodium and bad food and all that kind of stuff. So I do like to do this when I have the time. And what's interesting about this routine is she really does have the luxury of time that not a lot of people have, and money, because this whole routine is looking expensive already. But when you do have the time to do this, it's nice. It's nice to do. It's always nice to give yourself that kind of, what's the word? Just acknowledge that you're worth the time that you're putting into your routine, if you have the luxury of that time. But I get the puffiness.
So last but not least, the last massager that I use is Wand by Shawnee Durden. And I just come in, and again, I'm always just sort of holding my skin taut a little bit.
What is that? What is that? Shawnee Durden Skin Facial Sculpting Wand. 10-minute vibration treatment to firm and contour. Considered the secret behind Hollywood's most flawless faces. They always put the word Hollywood in if they want it to look, you know, creditable, real, I don't know. Soundwave therapy, free intensity levels. I mean, I've never seen this kind of thing before. This just looks like a massage wand, but for the face. I can imagine this feeling really good, and I'm tempted to buy it purely for that reason alone. But other than that, I don't know the science again. Lymphatic drainage, pulsing on the muscles, I don't really know. It looks like it will be an enjoyable luxury during a routine. That's, I think, all I can say about that.
After all that is done, I'm actually going to take a warm cloth and just take everything down a little bit, just because when I'm going to be applying makeup after this, I don't want anything to slip and slide. Just kind of take all of the serums.
So she's done her routine. She's put an oil on to massage her face, and now she's taking it all off again. Usually skincare takes a while to penetrate the skin, so you usually have to let it sit on your skin for a while before doing things like wiping your face. I would say, personally, do your massage before you wash your face, take off that oil, your all massage, and then you can apply your skincare, your serums, all that kind of stuff. Because now this looks like she's washed her face, she's done her steps, and now she's rinsing it all away because she's got that oil on top of her skin.
Just kind of take all of the serums and extra mask juice off.
And that's the thing, is you don't want to take them off, because that was an oil, not a serum. With serums, you want to leave them on the face. They're supposed to stay on the face. So that was an oil, and that's why I wouldn't use an oil in that stage, because it just doesn't feel good on your skin during the day. But I get it. I would have done that first thing and then washed my face and then continue with my routine, because now it just feels pointless a bit.
Speaking of which, now I'm going to take off my 24 karat boot masks. First things first, I like to come in with an under eye cream. This one is by Kiehl's. I'll take about that much.
That's a lot. That is a lot of eye cream. That is a lot. That's a lot.
So as you can see, I have a little melasma spot there. I also have a few more down here. That was courtesy of being pregnant. I'd say my skin actually didn't change that much when I was pregnant, except for the melasma. Thank you. It's fine. Little reminders. My little gift. The next thing that I do for my under eyes, which honestly is a big secret, it's this Basic Organics Vitamin E Wheat Germ Oil Aloe Vera. So I put about that much on, rub it in, and it's pretty sticky. So I just go in there and pat. I also pat it a little bit above my eye. I put it on heavier before I go to sleep at night, because in my mind, it feels like it helps my eyebrows grow. Put that over, a little bit over my lips, because it's vitamin E, so it doesn't hurt anybody. When I travel.
I think usually vitamin E is usually just a moisturizing ingredient, right? I feel like it's just a moisturizer. Okay, so an antioxidant and emollient. So yeah, I guess the doubling up of eye creams seems very a bit odd to me, but I feel like this is more of a makeup prep thing. Like for me, my under eye cream would have been those under eye patches and I kind of would have left it there. But it seems like she has her under eye makeup prep down to a T. I just need to take this off. Back, right. So let's have a look at this Basic Organics E ointment. Ointment. Ooh, I don't like that word. So we have wheat germ oil, vitamin E, and aloe vera. I mean, yeah, really, it just looks like a moisturizing product. Aloe vera, again, is soothing, can be quite hydrating and moisturizing along with wheat germ oil. So yeah, I guess it's just doubled up on the eye creams. I've not got a lot to say about that, really. A bit unnecessary, I feel. I feel like use one or the other.
I'm a lot more curious about skincare. So I always come home with a suitcase of new masks to try, or chin straps, as you guys saw earlier. I love seeing what other people use and what also like natural things. I know my mom growing up in the Philippines is, you know, such a huge believer of coconut oil and just everywhere. Skin, nails, cooking, hair, you name it, coconut oil. So I always find that to be really interesting when I travel, just getting a better sense of like what they use, what they've grown up using, and what their, you know, secrets are.
There's definitely something to be said as far as like cultural ties to natural skincare and natural medicine. And that, to be honest with you, whilst part of me doesn't like it because, you know, coconut oil doesn't do any harm. Is it the best? No, not really. And one thing I love about K-beauty is a lot of the brands seem to take traditional medicine that's science backed and use it in their skincare. And I find that super interesting. You know, you end up discovering ingredients that you never heard of before, plants that you've never heard of before. And, you know, whilst DIY and all natural stuff tends to not sit right with me when it comes to skincare, I think it's nice how there are certain things passed down through generations that, you know, worked for them, it'll work for you kind of thing. Is it always true? No, a lot of it is anecdotal evidence, often a placebo effect as well. But I do find it interesting that not all natural skincare has to be shooed away and like fuffed away, because a lot of it has some science behind it. It's just finding that right mix, and that right formulation as well.
This is a Super Serum Advanced Plus by IS Clinical. It just helps brighten your skin. I do about 3 drops.
Another serum? What did she just do? Hang on. Right, hang on. So she did the ointment and now she's doing the serum. It's clinical. That's $155. Wow. This is a super serum advanced plus, uses potent natural ingredients to heal, protect aging. Oh, so it's a vitamin C serum. Is a vitamin C serum. Okay, a very pricey vitamin C serum, which is fine. This routine is very all over the place for me. Like, I would find this quite like, oh, I'm going back and forth a lot. There's no real evidence behind the correct way to layer skincare, but essentially it's cleansing, hydrating, treatment, moisturizer, protection, being a sunscreen. And I would have put that massage before, but she seems to be doing the mask I would actually put with serums. So she's gone cleanser, serum, oil, cleansing with that damp cloth again, and then eye creams again, and then serum. I mean, it works for her, she looks great, but for me, it's a bit all over the place.
I always have to have sunscreen. So this is, again, my IS Clinical. This is SPF 50+.
I'm not gonna bother looking that up. Just use sunscreen, whatever it is. Doesn't matter how much it costs. If it's too expensive, affordable, whatever it is, if you're using sunscreen and you like a sunscreen, I'm just happy. You don't have to spend a fortune on sunscreen though. The serum was over $100, so I dread to think how much this one was. Okay, no, yeah, let's look it up. Oh, $45. Okay, that's not bad at all. That's not bad at all. They've linked to a tinted one, which I don't think is the one that she's using, but that's actually decent. But again, you can get good sunscreen for under $20, even $10 sometimes as well. So just find a sunscreen you love and just use it.
Okay, so now that that is sort of soaking in, I also have...
Sorry, she has a great way of applying her skincare. I feel like she's been taught how to do that.
I come in and take care of my lips right now just to give them some extra moisture. So when I'm applying my makeup, it's not all crackly. So I use Aquaphor.
I, funny enough, just use that on my eyebrows to protect the skin against the perming solution. Burn it a little bit here and here. But yeah, it's basically Vaseline.
Next moisturizer that I like to use is by Tata Harper, Illuminating Moisturizer.
Now, I'm not sure why she's using a moisturizer after a sunscreen. So she did go serum, sunscreen, moisturizer. And you need to go serum, moisturizer, sunscreen. I mean, is that essentially a primer? Is it a primer? No, it's a moisturizer. I mean, it does say here it has diamond dust for highlighting effect, but that's a moisturizer. That's a moisturizer. Yeah, so wrong position. I'm a bit worried about the next steps now.
My skincare is, as you can see, quite a lot. I don't know if Matt has picked up on really any of it. He's pretty simple with his skincare. So as much as I like to try and use him as like a little guinea pig when it comes to trying out new things, he's pretty basic and his skin is really good. It's really just me that's extra in the house. Atlas is now also though, like, always wanting me to spritz her face. If I ever do sort of like a water spritz or a little hydration thing, she always just stands there with her eyes closed. So I give her a little spritz of some water or something like that. Super cute. So as you can see, there's like a little sheen to it, but it's really subtle. And I just feel like the makeup just sits on top of it so nice. So last but not least, before I move on to makeup, I love to always start with this Fenty Beauty Spray. I also feel like if this is what Rihanna uses and this is what gets her skin to glow, then I probably should also drink it. I'm kidding, I'm not gonna drink it, don't drink this. Spray it, but you know, I just always think Rihanna. Now I'm gonna just...
So I feel like she was using that as a primer, really. I don't really know. That's confused me. Let's have a look at this Fenty Beauty Spray, because I'm guessing it's just like a hydrating spray. A super fine hydrating mist and travel makeup or foundation can be used under makeup for foundation prep. Okay, that's fine, yeah. So it's essentially just literally a hydrating spray. Fine. Yeah, whatever, fine. Nice. And then she's gonna go into makeup. So let's finish there. All right, I know I look like a mess, but I'm not ready. I'm getting ready. Oh God, I look terrible. I look really bad. So that wasn't the worst routine I've ever seen. Was it a bit everywhere? Yes. Is it really gonna make a massive difference to her routine? Not really, no. It's not gonna make a huge difference to her skin. It's not gonna do anything terrible. A little bit concerned about the moisturizer after the sunscreen. I mean, it shouldn't be the end of the world, but really you wanna put on your moisturizer, then put on your sunscreen. Just give it a couple minutes to, you know, settle onto the skin. It doesn't need to like become active or anything. And then use a primer and go in with your makeup. A lot of people use a sunscreen as a primer. A lot of them are very good at that. Just a lot, just very everywhere. But listen, the most important thing here is that she enjoys her routine. She's doing what clearly works for her. Yes, it's excessive. Yes, I love it and I can relate. If you have the luxury of time, if you have the luxury of money, why not? You can do all these steps you can find on a budget as well. I'm not mad at this. I'm not mad at this at all. I think all the multi-masking should have been classed as one step. But other than that, it's fine. It looked enjoyable. It did look enjoyable. Questionable things like the rose oil. It was an oil. It's not serum. Brands need to stop calling their oil concoctions serums. They're not. They're not. Stop doing that. It's very confusing. I'm not mad at this at all. She enjoyed herself. I enjoyed watching her enjoy herself as well. It makes me now want to go and redo my whole skincare routine and layer up all my masks and stuff. And no, it reminded me of the times that I used to love my 10-step routine. I used to, like she used to do, like buy all this Japanese and Korean skincare and just find out all these amazing new ingredients and tools and products. And yeah, I actually really enjoyed this. But yeah, there you go. My first skincare reaction for a long time. I hope you enjoyed it. I apologize for my state again. But yeah, you can watch some more skincare product reviews here and some general light entertainment here. And I'll see you over there.